Hi, it's Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. And look, it's October 28th. 2 days ago, it was 74. Today it's snowing. That's Wisconsin for you.
And no two are the same.
Well, look, after our snow shower, not a flake is on the ground. It only lasted a few minutes and then it was gone. And it did get a little chilly, but now it's in the 50s. It's beautiful out, sunny, bright. Our thoughts go out to all the people on the East Coast that are just waiting for that hurricane to hit. And then we think of Wisconsin, who, you know, last week we're thinking, oh, winter's coming. And now we're thinking, thank goodness we live in Wisconsin. It's beautiful here. Today, what we're doing is extending the grapevine. As you can see, they would like to go up a little bit higher, and the things that we've researched say that they should go up at least 5 feet. So we have a little extra pole now that Rick had these poles put in. So our next job is to put the extensions on. So I'm getting ready here to drill my hole. And then twist it in. Now there's a lot of tension that will be on this eyelet?
Yep.
Because not only will the wire be going through here, but then all of the weight of the grapevine, which believe it or not, turns out to be quite a bit. Yeah. Do I want to go one more or not? Okay. I'll give it a try. There, that's good. All right, so the next one will be up here, about a foot higher. Maybe a little higher?
Yep. Almost to the top.
Almost to the top. Too high.
Right there. Yep.
That'll be the next one.
I'll match the one on the other side.
Okay. And what we're using, like we used before, is a plastic-coated aluminum wire. And it's worked really well. It's easy on the vines. They seem to like it. They collect on there very nicely and wind around.
But we do have to remove many of these we thought would be big enough.
Right. We put little clips on there. And some of the smaller branches are fine, but you can see here, you know, these are getting bigger. They need to have a bigger loop.
Well, I think we're going to use nylon from stocking nylon to attach them.
Yes. Now this is how they weather. So when you have pantyhose or stockings, they really, really make a nice attachment. They're soft. They stretch. Free, because you've already paid for them, and you can collect them from your friends and family and co-workers.
Well, let's get this line up, and I've got to go to the hardware store and get another coil because I don't have enough.
We're running out.
To run a second row, so I'll let you get started on this, and I will, in fact, why don't you take the end of this and just...
Right, this is how it will look. So we'll go up here and through.
Then you're really going to pull.
I'll pull, and my magic hands, my extra magic hands will start twisting.
There you go. We'll just leave that in temporarily for now.
Oh, bless you. All right, you go on to the store and I'll do the actual work.
Yep, I'll let you unhook all these.
Thank you.
Okay.
I shall.
See you in a moment.
Okay. You're back. That was quick. And I see you bought a turnbuckle. Now, a turnbuckle is a really cool invention. that it has two different heads that could go on it depending on your need, and they come in all different size varieties, from very, very tiny to very industrial. And what happens then is you connect your line to the one end, you put the other end into your eyelet here, and then you can turn this part and it tightens it up more than you could ever tighten it by hand. So I am just doing this by hand first. I can already see that the kinks are coming out of it. And when it gets too hard, then I can use the pliers. Definitely, definitely different than the ones we did by hand.
Well, you could tune them like a guitar. Let the wind play nature's own tune.
Now, I don't know how tight we want this, actually, at this point.
Well, I think just tight enough, because we can always tighten it in spring.
Right.
And.
But that's really cool, because it doesn't interrupt whatever you have up here as far as having to take it off and re-stretch it. It just makes it tight from there. That's excellent. Good choice.
Well, you can also put them on both ends.
Sure.
So you can even have more adjustments if you need it. I mean, you know, they use these things on gates and doors, anything that needs to be adjusted and tightened.
Sure.
For support.
Right.
And whatnot.
And sometimes the posts move, the earth moves a little bit, the vines get heavy, and this is an excellent solution. Good thinking.
Well, I'm also going to add some 2x4s with 2x4 pads.
Right, over.
Kind of like a T, upside down T, and then support, you know, in different areas if need be, with an open screw eye that just kind of hooks onto it.
Sure.
And helps support it if need be.
Right.
So.
It depends on the weight and the amount of growth we get.
And I mean, if we have to, we'll put a third post right here in the middle.
Sure.
And then add some screw eyes, open screw eyes on there to help support the wire. So there are a lot of options.
Definitely are. Well, this is a good one. So let's get that second one up here and then we can start moving these vines around.
Sounds good.
Well, we're separating. It's like trying to unravel spaghetti. But what we're doing then is tying up with pantyhose that I've cut into strips, and we're tying them securely to the line, but also giving them some growth room here. So you can imagine, this is a pantyhose, this is a leg cut into fourths longwise and then cut into workable little pieces. So I put a loop around it. And then I put a loop around the actual wire itself. They're so soft that they do not bother the vine. It's perfect.
Well, now the whole task is training and cutting off the ones you don't want.
Right. That's the art. Which ones do you keep and which ones do you cut?
I'm sure a grape grower would kind of shudder when they see how we've allowed the base to kind of branch out here, rather than having one main stalk growing straight up and then teeing off. But this is the fun part of it, where you get to experiment and try something different. So we're not grape arborists, you know. We just grow grapes for the fun of it.
Doing what seems like a good idea and what gives us the best crop so far. So.
Now, where's that one going to go? Probably
know.
Over
I'm
here.
I'm trying to decide if I'm cutting this one or not.
Well, get rid of it. You don't want it.
Well, we've got.
Do you have any other main one coming
main
off of there?
One there. This main one kind of got cut off.
Yeah, then maybe keep that one and get that mm-hmm. one going straight up.
Easier said than done.
Good. good thing they're still flexible.
Yes. It's always good to keep a sense of humor about it, too. Alrighty. How do we want that one to go?
Yeah, right there is good.
Ooh, it's nice to have a third hand.
I always felt God should have given us at least one more hand, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he gives us his, so that's pretty spectacular.
Good. Yep.
But I could have used a third hand every now and then. Like most people could have.
Yep. That's why you made more than one person, so we can help each other.
That's right. It's all about sharing and caring.
There you go. And once they start sending their tendrils out.
And maybe this one you want to attach to the wooden support for the time being.
We have to get a bigger one for that. And the other nice thing is you can cut these to any length you want, so cut some longer, cut some shorter.
And even wider.
And wider, yep.
Now, when I was at the hardware store, I bought you some stuff. I think it's important you let people know.
Right, well, we bought this vinyl tape, which seemed like it would be wonderful. Let me get it.
Says it's a stretchable.
And they say it's stretchable, although it doesn't seem very stretchy. And then I got to reading the paper, the little advertisement, but there was a warning sticker on there that said in the state of California, this was known to be carcinogenic. So now we're thinking, well, it doesn't seem to really be working too well. Since we bought two of them, I think we'll take one back.
I think so too. We may take them both back. Just let them know about it, so.
Yep.
You know, why take the chance?
Right. And it isn't as flexible as the pantyhose are, so. Yeah. As long as we have those, we'll use them up and then ask others for more.
Well, that's a good idea.
Yes, it was. Well, we have finished our quest to keep our vertical vines going up and then letting them branch out the sides. We'll see how it looks in the spring, but it looks pretty good for now. Bye for now. It's getting nippy out here now.